Mine's meant to be flat to get in.
Mine's been all spinning. A bit too far.
It's in my low battery, isn't it? Yeah, I haven't got no. Oh, it looks like that's coming up. Yeah, it's found it up enough. Flat out, look, it should go up. Five bombs, isn't it? Not very thin. That's calibrated now.
Not done now. I don't know if this is a good idea, but running this little charger of ours, 4.5 amps, I'm just not struggling to charge it now. Get yawing now a little bit.
What the?
See that little yaw around it, though? Straight away, that. Smallest of adjustments. Playing it with holding the sticks differently. How the foes hold them.
So, Sunday, bank holiday weekend. Here showing Wizard X220. My first flight FPV with accelerometer off. My Wizard took a good hiding, so today I've got to replace the props. They're all smashed. The VTX's PCB's broken. So I'm going to move the VTX, I think, forward on the top plate. Solder a new PCB in if that's possible. Put a pigtail on it so this doesn't happen again. And then I've got to connect it to Betterflight, turn the accelerometer on, and my angle horizon channels. GoPro coming today, but no mount as of yet. Over. Here we have Kevin's project. He's taken the dubbings out of his X220S and he's placing them in a almost a chameleon frame. Alright, all you shine lizard users out there, if you look at my motor here, you can see the thread is damaged. It's not damaged from the top, so that is proof that I didn't put my nut on incorrectly. These nuts have got a rubber locking mechanism right on the top. Right on the top, just there. And that's what caused mine to be too tight. And lucky enough, my brother Kev cleaned the thread up for me. There will be a new one on order. So beware. There's my 4 ASCs soldered in the right place using this diagram that I made. Yes. The new flight controller is in, I've just soldered it in. You can see my dodgy soldering first attempt. Here's the old board. I don't know which one's the fake one, but yes, completed. Does it work? Find out tomorrow. For some reason, after changing the flight controller, because I had an arming issue, my S-bus / I-bus connection don't work. So I've changed it over to PPM. And now it works. Which is very, very odd. And the motor is spinning. So I had a crash, first time FPV, broke the VTX PCB and numerous other problems presented themselves, but it's back. Might not have enough battery in that. Battery is fully charged. I
them pots slightly bent, you don't want to fire it smooth. One of the pots is facing down a little bit. We just fired again. And it's